Welcome to Palouse Falls State Park. So it's mid-January. We're just south of Washtenaw, and this is the Palouse River Falls. The falls is about 180 feet from there to there, which that's kind of crazy to think about. And actually somebody went over that in a kayak, which that's pretty impressive. There's a video of it, and you can just find that on YouTube. But yeah, it's an interesting park. And we're gonna kind of delve into the geology of this place some. There's some trails around here, we'll walk those. A bunch of people have died here, of course. So four people have died since 2016, and like 17 or 18 have gotten airlifted out because people walk up to the edge and they fall right in. And who knows how many dogs have gone in the drink here, enough to probably be really sad. So everything that you see here is a relatively new geological feature. If you go back to my geological tour video where we went to Steptoe Butte and we look at the hills of the Palouse, all of eastern Washington looked like that. Those nice rolling hills of lis, which is like dirt that's kind of like flour, very loose stuff. And you can actually see up there some of those hills, and you saw some of the hills when we were coming in. So about 10,000 years ago, none of this was here. And the the Palouse River actually paralleled the Snake, and as the Missoula Floods came down, they were coming down through Cheney and south and crashing into the basaltic ridge that's about 5 miles south. And that extreme amount of water, hundreds of feet of water blasting through this region, eroded the basaltic ridge and created a giant, giant waterfall. So the Palouse here, the Palouse River, did not actually create any of what you see here. So this whole coulee was made by the Ice Age floods. And, you know, a river that's going through a valley where you get that V in it, that's created either through the river cutting it or the river holding its own and the land rising up around it. And then if you get one that's like a lobe shape, that's from a glacier carving it out. Coulee is from a waterfall cutting back. So as that Ice Age waterfall went over that ridge and into the Snake, it started to fracture this basalt. You can see how fractured this stuff is, and break it off and send it away. You can see across the way here all of the fractures in that. So even though the Palouse is here now, it wasn't the one that created this. The old channel that the Palouse went into is called the Washtenaw Coulee, and that actually dumps out into the Columbia, kind of where the Fur Road area is now. Like if you go back and watch the agate hunting videos out there, I believe a lot of that material that you see out in like West Richland, out in the Tri-Cities and stuff, was deposited by the Palouse before the last ice age when it was running out there and depositing its material. Not 100% sure, but it's definitely something I'd like to investigate in the future. So one thing that you can see here is all these different layers. You can see layer, layer, layer. So all of those basaltic flows are different. Well, they're different flows. The bottom kind of big three that you see there, the big three that you see there at the bottom are the Grand Ronde basalts, and then that much thicker one is the Wanapum. And I actually have this kind of cool cross-section picture here, and you can kind of see what I see, which is pretty neat. You can read that. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put that in, and you can just look at it yourself, and we'll maybe do some type of overlay. But this is a really interesting canyon. I mean, the fact that it's receded 5 miles from the Snake, and we're going to head down there next, but the fact that those were able to erode so much of this highly fractured basalt is really cool. This is also the perfect time of year to come out here. You know, it's no one's here. We have this whole place to ourselves. State park back there where you can camp, do those state park things. But it's pretty neat. There's also that big ice disc down there that's slowly rotating and acquiring more ice.
Take it out.
That's pretty good. It's really hard to imagine this landscape during the Ice Age floods as the Missoula ice dam broke, because, you know, the waterfall is 185 feet or so, and then you would have 200 or 300 feet of water, muddy water with giant chunks of ice and rocks coming over this. Just an absolute raging landscape carving off this basalt. So the Palouse Falls is over there. So we're up above it now. There's that little fall. You can still really see even up here some of the basalt flow layers. That'd be a tough way to go, falling down the cliff. But here, you know, we're looking down the coulee. You can really kind of imagine a waterfall working its way up here, slowly eroding at the edge. Currently, Palouse Falls has this kind of like undercut pocket that goes back into the cliff. And then I think stuff is fracturing off and falling into the river, not actively like today, but over the past 10,000 years, that's kind of what has been happening. Maybe it's time for a drone eventually.
Yeah, that'd be good.
When the DJI Mavic Minis, something like that, be able to fly around, check out some of the stuff like this up close. There's a road over there that works its way down to that other side, but it's just like a dirt double track. So not snowy winter conditions, but very pretty out here.
Feels moist up here.
Yeah. Well, you can feel the spray coming out of the pool at the bottom.
Foggy.
You can see right there, somebody's a foot away from the edge, not even knowing if that's an edge or snow. Foolishness. Scablands sure are cool. So right now we're down in Lions Ferry. We are 5 miles downstream of the Palouse Falls. You're looking upstream at that. This is the Columbia River right there. That's the bridge, 291. And kind of wanted to come down here to point out how much erosive power there is behind the Ice Age floods. All of that continued all the way over, and this was just a giant waterfall, and all of that basalt got washed out during it. It's hard to even imagine that right there, which is probably at least 300 feet, and then another 300 feet of water on top of that, rushing over that edge and into the Columbia. What do you think?
Yeah.
Hard to imagine?
Huh?
Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that. Hit the subscribe button if you'd like to see more geological tours of Washington and Idaho and other areas.